right. Welcome, everyone. This is Judith Marchand. You're listening to Musical Notes on PANJ Radio. And we have a band here. I'm really kind of speechless because I've been working to get this band on since I started. And they're one of my most favorite, I mean, don't tell anyone else because, you know, of course, I love all of the bands in Lambertville. But these guys, you're just... We're going to just start out with a song so you know why I love them so much. So this is the River City Healers. We've got Tony, Daniela, Alan, and Pat, and I'm just thrilled. So why don't you guys go ahead and play some music for us?
This first one we're dedicating to you also. Oh,
thank you. Yay. Unexpected.
That's why we couldn't.
So did you write that?
Yeah, you asked us the name of it. Oh, like,
that's it.
This is really
now it's
old,
all making
traditional
sense.
Melody from the America. It is no longer copyrighted.
Thank you guys. Well, that was wonderful to commemorate my 21st birthday. I appreciate that. Oh, well, awesome. All right, well, let me also introduce our co-hosts. We have David Horowitz here to my left. Thank you for joining me.
Good evening.
David, I have Audrey Burns here to my right.
Hello.
Thank you so much. I have David Hahnemann, who...
The voice of God.
Yes. Absolutely. He's also running the soundboard today. Thank you, David.
Soundboard God.
Yeah, soundboard God. I have Mark Fulkowski doing the YouTube video feed, so... Thank you, guys. And why don't we start out with just some brief introductions? Why don't you tell me your name, where you live, and like what role you play in the band? So, all right, Tony, it's all you.
Okay, my name is Tony Kovach. I used to live in Lambertville, but I live in Plainsboro now, and I'm the accordion player in the band.
Love the accordion. I'd never understood how you doing one thing with your left hand, another thing with your right hand, all these different keys and buttons. And
I don't really understand it either.
It amazes me.
Thanks.
Awesome. All right, Daniela.
Hi, I'm Daniela Fischetti. I am the fiddle player. I am also the librarian. I am also the...
Band mom.
I have to call all the practices. I have to call Pat and tell him to get everywhere an hour earlier than everywhere else. I host the practices in my house. I live in Lambertville.
Excellent.
And
you run a circle over at the Birdhouse, too,
yes,
right?
I help host a monthly bluegrass jam at the Birdhouse Center for the Arts,
so
which
fun.
Is the last Wednesday of every month, in case anyone wants to check it out.
Oh, it's a blast.
It's a real good time.
Mm-hmm. All right, Alan?
I'm Alan Rigoletto. I'm a relative newcomer to Lambertville, and I am very much a newcomer to the River City Healers. So past couple months have been kind of like, you know, fast-paced, learning all the tunes for the band and everything, and throwing my tunes out and everything. So.
Yeah. Well, we're so glad to have you.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Glad to be here.
Yay.
My name's Pat Knapp. I'm the resident oaf in the band, as most bass players are. As Danielle said, it's her job to make sure I don't screw things up too wildly. So I'm just the guy dragging the club through the band.
But then they're to elevate
the rest of these fantastic musicians I get to play with.
Well, you got to have that bass, though.
Oh,
so very important.
The oaf is an important role. You can't overstate that.
That's right. That's absolutely. So and are you missing any members, or you had a previous member that's not here with us today? Yes. The founding member?
Oh, right, our founder emeritus,
yes.
Kristen Bradley.
Who actually introduced a lot of us.
Yeah. Or at least he introduced me to you guys.
Yeah, Christian rolled into town as he is wont to because he was the gypsy who started stuff. He rolled through, gathered us all together, and then went about his merry way.
The true gypsy.
So we're sure he's doing the same thing somewhere else now, and he'll keep moving around.
Gypsy angel.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Right, there you go.
Planting the seeds.
Yes, exactly.
Well, and when did you guys form? When and how did that come about?
Was it 2014?
Yeah,
in the wintertime.
Yeah, 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. And I had met our founding guitar player, and we were playing a little bit, and then we dragged Pat into it, who we knew through other musical projects going on, and then we found Tony, and we dragged him into it.
Dragged
him. Yeah.
Once, I haven't found a way out yet.
Once we heard him, we just... Yeah, pulled him in, and that was
trying.
That. And then we knew Al just from the great music scene mm-hmm. around town. He was just a perfect fit. So,
awesome.
Yeah.
And how did you get your name?
It was a bit of a collaboration. We wanted to incorporate the river, and, you know, river cities have this momentum with the river and mm-hmm. transient... you know, just kind of like a flowing theme. So yeah, it was a collaboration. We've been considering, I don't know, maybe throwing out other names.
Yeah, we're kind of on the verge of a possible name change, but with River City Healers, it's kind of like music should be there to heal, and mm-hmm. we're based in the River City, so it just came together that way. But yeah, we're on the fence about it. We might be moving off in a different direction that way, but...
We're fickle.
Okay.
Every 6 months or so, you just change
it. Right, yeah. Keep people on their toes.
Yeah.
I like the name, personally, because I love the River City here, Lambertville, New Hope area, and I find music very healing, so... Especially your kind of music. So, but tell us a little bit about what kind of music you play. It's different from the typical bar scene, you know, open mic kind of music. How would you describe it?
Well, it's a real mix of klezmer, gypsy jazz, folk music. I mean, we're going to be playing a Christmas tune from medieval England in a few minutes. So we really try to mix it up as much as possible.
And tell us what klezmer is. Some audience members might not know what that is.
Oh, klezmer is, I think, Eastern European Jewish folk
mm-hmm.
music.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we do a lot of Eastern European stuff. Mm-hmm. So, like, the traditional gypsy melodies that came out of there, the folk music, Russian melodies, that kind of thing. And then the gypsy jazz, of course, was Django Reinhardt and Stefan Grappelli. They took these traditional melodies and melded it with... the jazz music that is mm-hmm. going on, and they formed this new sound. So we also like to take different songs, like our medieval Christmas song, and play it in those styles.
Yeah.
Because it's fun.
We kind of started with the Grappelli stuff, and so we were calling ourselves Gypsy Jazz, but then as we progressed, we realized that wasn't really appropriate. So I think as of late, we've been calling ourselves Gypsy Folk, just because mm-hmm. you take that influence and then like, all right, yeah, something else from Russia, something from klezmer tunes, something, if, you know, find something with a good South African beat that you can throw in there, just taking a little bit of everything and then seeing what comes up.
Yeah, there also tends to be kind of a highbrow element that goes along with gypsy jazz players and gypsy jazz, and, you know, we're not entirely trying to be that.
Not a highbrow
low
group.
Brow.
Middle brow?
Yeah. Yeah.
Middle brow.
Moderate brow music.
Moderate brow music.
That's our new tagline.
Yeah.
There you go. Well, I love it. I have on my father's side, I have an Eastern European background. With my grandmother's German Jewish, and my grandfather was his family escaped the genocides in Armenia.
Oh wow!
They were Jewish, and they actually immigrated into the French part of Canada, which is why I have a French name, Marchand, but I'm not actually French. So I think part of that is why your music just really resonates with me. So
yeah, it's pretty crazy too. When we play out, there are always people that come up to us and they're like, "I love that music. I'm Ukrainian, you know, whatever it is, whatever nationality, that's the music. I haven't heard it in so long. Mm-hmm. It brings me back to whatever." So it's pretty cool that because a lot of stuff we'll
never hear it out.
We just find, like I said, I just scour the internet for music and collections of songs and that kind of thing, and you just pick some because they sound pretty, but they're well-known melodies that
well, it's touched
people
so many
know.
People's lives across Europe over the many years because gypsies traveled.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right.
And,
yeah.
and they right. were known to be musicians and other things, of course, but music brought everybody together, big crowds, so they were working the crowds constantly.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and they knew their minors very well.
Yes.
That's the key to everything.
Yeah, minor key, yeah. Well, let's hear another song. What do you think?
Sure. I think we'll play our medieval Christmas tune that Tony referenced earlier. Mm-hmm. But we're going to jazz it up for you. And we also, we submitted this for the annual holiday CD that the Historical Society puts out. But we were unable to perform at any of the concerts because our schedules just didn't work out, so...
But
we'll
you're on the CD.
We are on the CD, okay. And we'll play it for you again now.
Awesome. Yay. Wonderful. River City Healers, folks. Thank you.
That's fantastic.
That's just awesome. All right, well, so let's tell the audience, since they've gotten a real taste of your music, where can they hear more of it? Because if they're like me, they're like, more, more, more. Are you online? You have a Facebook website? What have we got going?
I think you have some. We have a show in January in Morristown.
Oh, Morristown. Cool. Do tell.
Yes, so Friday, January 20th at the Morristown Decafé, which is 395 Kings Highway in Morristown. So it's the South Jersey, not Morristown in the North.
Oh, Morristown. Okay.
Doors open at 7:30. Music is at 8:15. There's a website for it if you check out the Morristown Decafé. And they do, I think it's a monthly thing. They've been having some pretty cool acts go through there, so it's going to be fun. We're looking forward to it.
All right. I didn't know about that place. Cool. Is that Decafé? D-E. Okay.
D-E, yeah. Right.
And is this on your Facebook page and or website?
It will be soon.
and you're on Facebook as the River City Healers,
yes.
Right?
That's right. Yeah. That's the best place to get a hold of us now, just because we're all kind of Luddites with a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff is kind of lapsing, but our Facebook page is probably the best place to follow us on and see what we have going on.
Okay, very good. And I know you have stuff on YouTube, too.
Yes, we have YouTube. Mm-hmm.
Good.
Yeah, we're not great at the internet presence thing.
You're on the internet.
Right now. Yeah.
We will work on that.
Look, we play the music. Isn't that enough?
Yeah. If anyone wants to be our manager, the position is open.
Putting that out there.
Just need a truck, gas money, those kinds of things.
Yeah.
Right. You played at the local recently. That was really fun.
Last week, a couple weeks,
a blast.
Yeah, we'll probably have some more local stuff.
Yeah,
coming up. Some of that's kind of last minute, but we will be sure to put it on our website so everyone knows.
We're not.
We'll certainly announce
on Facebook. Yeah.
I have a question that's been floating in my head. Do any of your instruments have a name? Have you pet named any of your instruments?
Oh, that's a good question.
Ooh,
Danielle is blushing.
Her? Are you talking about her? This is La Senora.
I did not know that.
Yeah, now you know. She can be kind of pushy sometimes. She's, La Senora.
I think Tony's his name.
Tony on
the side of the corner.
Yeah, we'll post a picture of that too, so everyone listening.
Tony's gonna be really simple.
Yeah. Tony Jr.
Yeah. I just now decided that this guitar is named Dan because this is a Godan, and so when I play, it's like Godan.
It's a very cool guitar.
Not sure if I'll stick with that.
Can you tell us a little bit about the guitar? It's kind of an interesting guitar.
Yeah, do tell, yeah.
Yeah, well, this is kind of a modernized classical guitar. And I know that my guitar professor in college would probably have me throw the thing out a window because it is in no way a traditional classical guitar because it has the thinner body and the strap and there's no sound hole and everything. But I got it because I'll do like a 3-hour gig. And, after sitting with a classical guitar for 3 hours, it's just, there's lots of aches and pains that go on. So this has completely eliminated all those.
Because it's so much lighter.
It's lighter, it's thinner, and I have a strap and everything, so it's pretty nice.
Awesome.
Is there a bass name?
Bass has no name. Me and this bass have a troubled relationship. upright basses are very expensive, and by the time I got into upright, I'd spent about 5 years buying electric basses every chance that I could get. Mm. So that by the time this came around, I was like, I'd love to. Oh, wait, it's $3,000 to start.
Wait, Pat, I can solve this problem for you. The electric basses?
No, I'm not selling those. Shut down.
You didn't even hear what I had to say.
Finish what you were saying.
I kind of intuited where you
Pat,
were.
Pat, sell those bases.
Sell those
bases.
This is like a Pete Seeger, Bob Dylan moment.
This is the first upright bass that I bought, and it is a bit of a beginner's model. I believe it's a Carlo Rebelli, and much like Alice, it's a thin line, so it's about half the thickness of a proper upright bass, which can affect its overall resonance.
But in a situation like this, I would, you know, have a microphone, or it does have a jack going out, and I can get a good enough sound going through an amp. That, again, it's kind of a workhorse, troubled relationship, just because it's not all it could be, but, you know, we get by. Mm-hmm. It's like one of those marriages where you've been along after, it's like, ah, we'll make it work.
Well, let's keep it simple. Let's call it Tony.
Yeah. Tony 2.
Tony 2.
It's not yelling at me or beating at me, so, you know, it'll be all right. Yeah. Well, what about, tell us about your instrument, Tony.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You
don't see accordions in every band.
Tony's been sitting here. Please ask me about Tony.
I thought you'd never ask.
Please ask me about Tony.
Actually, I spent all summer demoing accordions and talking about them, so I could literally go on for an hour about the accordion.
Okay, give us the condensed version.
this is a technically full-size accordion, but it's compact, so it has all the buttons of a full-size accordion, which is 41 treble keys and 120 bass buttons.
Wait. How 121? You're doing 121 buttons with one hand and 40 keys with the other hand.
41.
Okay, yeah, my brain just exploded.
Yeah, 41
treble
keys,
half a piano.
Okay. All the melody stuff. And then over here you have your bass buttons.
Oh my god.
And then it has 13 different registers, which means that I can get...
Because you need more buttons.
Right, yeah.
Like all these different settings, so...
I'm sure
it might be
that.
Overkill.
And you want him to give up his electric bass.
How do you do all... That just blows my mind. This is so much.
Because Tony's got Vaughn. Yeah.
Tony's
right?
Like, yeah, well, I just do it because I can.
But here's what I say. I don't want to discourage people from playing it, because actually, think about this. If you're playing the piano, you play the melody with your right hand most of the time, right?
Yeah.
And with your left hand, you have to spell out all of the accompaniment.
Right.
So if you're playing a C major chord, you have to play the C, the E, and the G. Mm-hmm. But if I play a C major chord, all I have to do is press one button.
Oh.
So which one is harder?
Oh.
Easy peasy.
So,
okay.
Of course, you have to learn all these complicated like diagonal rows and how they relate to each other.
Right, without
and
looking.
It's arranged by the circle of fifths, so it's not intuitive. Like to go up, you go down a lot of the time.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. But once you learn the way it's laid out, in a way, it's easier.
Wow.
Than piano.
Well. It still boggles my mind.
Why are some of the buttons sparkly? Like that one has sparkle.
Those are my reference points.
Oh.
So the main reference point is right here in the middle. There's an indent, and that's my C.
The sparkly button?
Is the sparkle the indent?
It's a little diamond on it.
Nice.
And we're also ignoring the fact that you're pumping it, creating airflow
right.
into the
yeah,
machine.
Yes.
So all
right.
that's going on while you're actually moving the machine back
exactly.
and forth.
Unbelievable.
Yep.
All right, well, we could talk all day about that, but I know you guys want to get in one more song before we go to our break, so why don't we go ahead and do that song, and then we can get back to Tony's instrument for the next half
Please.
Hour. Yeah. All right, River
so
City Healers.
We're
going
to play an Alan Rigoletto original here,
Ooh, yay.
Which he brought to us, and Excellent. We are pretty excited about.
Yeah, the funny story about this tune was I had the Healers in mind when I was writing it, just kind of thinking about the sound and everything, and had no idea at that point in time I was going to be actually performing this tune with River City Healers.
Before you were part of the group, very cool.
It's a weird destiny thing.
Premonitions.
All right, let's
hear. This one's called Oh My.
Okay.
Wake me up in the summertime, hang my limbs up out to dry, oh my. Oh my, oh my. I see you baking in the morning light. The caps off ready for the 4th of July. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Like a centipede swinging its legs about, I found a little crack in the wall. Harmonies, melodies are overrated till that ringing bell rings your call. I wouldn't do much, but I would do it well. It's the same old story, but it's mine to tell. Oh my, oh my, oh my.
Mm-hmm.
clouds all white, but the snow ain't here. The weatherman says there's nothing to fear. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Birds are chirping up a storm in a tree. I guess that's all the storm I need. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Like a terrified, terrible army of mice, I found a little crack in the wall. Home is a homey, a kind of place when the soldiers start to brawl. I put down my pen and I went outside. The world's a big place, so I went far and wide. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Need one thing, need it more than anything, till it all goes my way. Oh, I want 1% of what I find to make just a little more sense this time. Oh my, oh my, oh my. Oh my, oh my, oh my. If it makes more sense to you, then it makes more sense to me.
Well, we got to go to a quick break here. We will be right back with more Oh My music from the River City Healers, and we'll hear some more about them and their group. So don't go away. Don't change your URL. Don't move your mouse. We will be right back on PANJ Radio. This is Musical Notes. I'm Judith Marchand. We'll see you in just a few short minutes. All right, welcome back, everybody. This is Judith Marchand. You're listening to Musical Notes on PANJ Radio. And we have this kick-ass band here, the River City Healers. I am just thrilled. We've got Pat, Alan, Daniela, and Tony. And they've got us up and moving over here at the radio station. They're going to start us right into another song. And so why don't you guys just go ahead and hit us with it.
Thank you.
been listening to your music in my car. It like, especially in the morning, like I'm tired, I'm driving to work, and it gets me going. And I've been listening to your CD. Do you have this CD? Can you tell me a little bit about like where the CD was recorded and when, kind of thing?
Yeah, we recorded that at Puck in Doylestown. We did a
great venue.
Live recording of it.
That place has such great sound there that not doing a recording there is kind of like just practice enough to get that, because you can always get a recording out of that.
It's amazing. It does not sound live. Like it sounds like in a studio. Yeah, that's great.
And we did that
a year and a half ago. Something like that.
Yeah.
Awesome.
But yeah, that's our first one. We're in the midst of getting another one going again. I think we're going to try to do an EP coming up soon.
Yeah,
good.
Some of our new material out and
With Alan in it now.
Yeah,
excellent. So, and some of your material is you do some originals, right? So, who writes the originals?
Well, I write a lot, and Al also has been bringing the originals,
yeah,
which is great. You know, we get his skills. He also brings all these new tunes with him.
Just sucking them dry.
Yeah.
It's so great to be able to have someone who can take a guitar solo at this point.
What more could you want?
Yeah, actually, Tony wrote that last one that we played, which is called Defiance.
Excellent.
Yeah, he writes some really awesome stuff.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about how you write songs. Like, what inspires you?
I usually just start by noodling around, and when I find a melody that I like, I build on it, and I feel like I really am focused on chord progressions, so I really like to try to find interesting chord progressions first, and then add the melodic material on top. So I think that's what I did with Defiance. I really liked that chord progression first, and then started adding these, you know, melodic lines on top of that.
Very cool.
Didn't you just publish a book of your songs in the summertime?
Oh, I did. Thanks for bringing that up. Yeah.
A whole book of songs.
Right, like I said, I was working in an accordion shop this summer, and I published a book.
The man who can talk for hours about accordions?
Actually, if you go on YouTube and you look up Liberty Bellows...
Yeah, Liberty Bellows.
There are like thousands of... demonstration videos featuring Tony Kovac trying out hundreds. Okay. Close to 1,000.
Seems like 1,000, Wow.
So there were the demo videos, and then I did a whole 50 video course for the accordion.
Wow.
Sounds like a competitive market.
Can be.
Well, I'm sure there aren't that many good instructors.
Yeah, there's really not a whole lot out there, honestly.
I would think. Yeah.
So we really kind of built a brand new curriculum.
Excellent.
When we made these videos.
Excellent.
I was listening to Julian Welsh being interviewed the other day, and she was talking about being on tour, and it kind of brought a question to my mind. If you had a chance to tour with anyone, who would you tour with?
Ooh, that's a good question.
Dead or alive.
Pat and Tony.
There you go.
With each other.
Right answer.
There you go. Well, she was talking about a time she was on tour with Johnny Cash, and it sounded like, wow, what a place to be.
Oh, yeah.
It's really incredible.
Well, what have been some of your influences musically? I mean, I'm sure some of the music are not bands that are currently still playing, the old world kind of influences, but are there any current influences?
Well, I'll go back to your question. I would probably tour with Punch Brothers.
Oh, cool.
Because Gabe Witcher, who's the fiddle player in that band, is one of my favorites. He's just so good, and Chris Thiele obviously is pretty awesome too, but I can just imagine the picking that happens when they're not on stage.
Right. Yeah, after stuff,
pretty amazing.
Very cool.
Or like good times hanging out.
When you're on tour, you take it all into like A, who's a musical idol or whatever, and then B, who's cool? Who do you want to hang out with, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty important part of it.
I think it's most of it,
Yeah, you need to tour with cool folks or else.
Exactly. What's the point?
Yeah. Well, when you guys go on tour, you know, I can fit in your suitcase. So.
Well, you're going to be our manager.
Okay. Sign me up.
Suitcase manager.
Suitcase manager.
I'll be the bodyguard.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Honestly,
sound man.
I don't think we've ever played a show
where you weren't the show.
I think you've literally been at every show.
You were the
ever
one
played
in Flemington?
Yeah.
Yeah. That weird one?
Honestly,
any
time Judy shows up to the show before I do.
Yeah. Maybe you can just bring him from now on.
I could do that. I don't know if his face will fit in my little Hyundai. We can try.
You strap it on the top.
Yeah. Hey, I work at a tree farm. I know how to strap stuff on top of shit. So. Excellent. Well, yeah. I mean, Bill always says when I show up, then it's actually a real music venue then. So.
Yes.
Put your stamp approval on them.
That's it. Yeah. Well, all right. So since we're talking about how much I love your music, let's play some more music. Yeah. What do you think? You got another song to do?
Sure. We're going to do another Tony original.
All right.
He named this Reconstellation Waltz. He told me it's a made-up word.
It is.
I was thinking about that today.
Yeah.
Glad to know it's made up.
Yeah. I made it up, yeah.
I'm like, crap, I missed that one.
How do you come up with these names, Tony?
How did this one come up? I was reading a book about constellations and how they will... Well, I think it was about astronomy at large and how the constellations are constantly changing. And then I made up that word to describe that, reconstellation.
They're reconstellating themselves.
They're reconstellating. Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And when it catches on, you can use it to describe all sorts of things.
Right.
Well, and you guys are kind of reconstellating.
We reconstellated ourselves.
Yeah, wow. Epiphany.
Sounds painful.
That's reconstellations.
That's awesome.
And that could be the RC, reconstellation.
There you go.
Whoa. Wow.
It all started here.
All right. Wow. And it's all on film.
Yeah.
Wait, what'll be the H though?
Constellations. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, hell yeah.
No. Sell your electric basses, then we
Shut
can talk.
Oh, ooh, zing. All right, let's play some music.
Okay. Thank you.
I could just, can you guys just stay for another 2 hours after the sure. And just play for me? Oh, I love it.
I don't have any plans.
We got enough wine.
Yay. Well, I wondered
we'll stay as long as there's something to drink.
Oh, hey, we've got. And Christmas cookies.
Around the corner.
Yeah, oh, that's true.
New Year's is around the corner.
I wondered if you could just briefly tell me a little bit more about you individually, maybe like where you're from and kind of how you got into music, a little bit like that. What do you think?
Let's start on that side.
Okay. Oh. Right. Starting with Pat.
So I've been playing pretty much in and around, I think I started playing in New Hope. Started playing up in Flemington, but didn't really start playing gigs until I got down to New Hope. First band was a Grateful Dead and Fish cover band, so yeah. Got started strong there. Mm-hmm. And honestly, it was me, two brothers, and their dad. And we started playing in their basement, got some other guys with us, did that. Then me, the two brothers broke off, and we formed a band called Skips Museum that played in and around the area for the better part of 10 years. But then as people get older, you know, kids, wives, mortgages, all that stuff, certain people went around, but I was the only one who didn't have any of those three things. So I just started finding other people to play music with. So, but yeah, pretty much I've just been floating around. If you hang around, if you can play an instrument and hang around in New Hope and Lambertville long enough, you're going to find other people.
You find people, yes, yeah. I agree.
That's been my outlook. It's been working out pretty well so far.
Now, are you from Lambertville originally?
No, I grew up in Union, New Jersey, and then moved out to Flemington when I was about 10 or 11, and gotcha. Then once I was old enough to drive, I just needed to drive out of that town. Ended up towards Lambertville and New Hope.
What about nice. Formal training?
Formal training? No, I played trumpet when I was a kid, and then going back to old basses because they're important. I told my uncle my uncle was not a famous musician, but he played around for years, and I said, oh yeah, I think I want to play the bass. He said, okay. So the one day he came over and gave me a 78P bass and a 78 bass man's 15 said, these are yours now, learn how to play. And I just started, playing by ear. I don't have the, these guys have the charts in front of them, it all makes sense to them. I just see, big blobs for the most part. But I was like, oh, I know what that blob is, and I know what that blob is. But I've been playing long enough where I have enough of an ear to know how things are supposed to sound. So, but just by doing that long enough, it just led me to being able to, step in with people who were totally competent and be able to follow along with them.
So you said awesome. A 78P bass.
78P bass, still got that. I still...
And you want him to sell that?
Sell it!
You?
Sell it! Sell
no!
It.
No!
A literal, no! A literal family heirloom no. That got me started along the way.
Sell it!
Yeah, there are two bass players in the room. There.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
One of you. I'd
we're
back
outnumbered,
off.
Danielle.
Back off, yeah.
All right, how about you, Alan?
Well, starting at the way beginning, I started playing piano when I was 5, and once my parents got around to buying me an actual upright piano when I was 11, I was like, hey, guitar sounds really cool. And then I got a loaner, my friend's mom gave me a 66 Yamaha FG110, which I was told was great, and I did lots of things to it, and kind of destroyed it. I didn't actually destroy it, friend's mom, if you're listening. Then
he sold it.
Yeah, I started playing a whole lot of, I started really getting into rock and roll and doing Jimi Hendrix solos, and I started getting into metal and everything like that. And those days are behind me because then I started to realize I needed to learn something formal, and I started to pick up classical guitar and jazz, and then. There's a whole lot of schooling and everything that went on after that. And long story short, I've done countless performances on classical guitar. I've toured Europe with a psychedelic rock band, and I've put out my own album as a singer-songwriter, and now you're seeing the updated me playing this cool stuff.
Awesome.
Great.
It's an endless journey.
That sounds great, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
How about you, Danielle?
Well, I'm not from Lambertville. I grew up in western Morris County, so about a little over an hour north of here. And when I was in elementary school, my mom signed me up for fiddle lessons. Local fiddle player, Lou Gelfon, he used to live in Califon, was giving... Do you know him?
I know Lou, yes.
Lou's the
Lou
best,
Gelfon.
Yeah. So he was
Cowsing,
doing...
none of it, him and Ralph Litwin.
he was doing an after school program, so I started taking lessons with him. And then I switched teachers. I think Lou left. I don't know what happened. I switched teachers, and then I eventually
he moved
ended
down
up,
south.
He had a, yeah, he was in the process of moving. I think he's in Asheville now.
Yeah, he got ill, I believe, is what happened, and he needed to...
Yeah, get out of the Jersey water.
Yeah, yes.
I see him at Grey Fox now, which is awesome, when we hang out and jam, which is a lot
That's
of fun,
cool.
My first teacher. But then I studied with a strict classical teacher all through middle school and high school. And then in college I studied... classical, but I had always been playing bluegrass and jazz and other kinds of music, so luckily I could make the switch out of the very rigid classical world. Yeah.
Very cool. Great. And Tony, you were just born playing your instrument
story.
There. Yeah.
So let's play another song.
Yeah. Came out of the womb and you were just playing. So.
There you go. That is the beginning and end.
That's okay.
That was a tough labor.
It was a full-size accordion.
Oh, God. Your poor mom.
But, yeah, I'm actually from Pittsburgh. Played lots of instruments growing up. I was actually a guitar player in college, music major. Towards the end, I was getting a little bored of playing the guitar because I'd been playing it for so long. So I started to get into the accordion. It wasn't until I moved out here and started actually accompanying my girlfriend, Kim,
right?
My wonderful girlfriend of 11 years.
Yes, who sings French.
She sings French music, which is really hard. And so I had to learn how to play the accordion. So that's where I got all my chops from, was learning these songs. And then I met these guys. And
so you learned to play the accordion for love.
Pretty much.
Exactly. And you got bored of the guitar?
I was waiting for that.
Everyone's different now.
wait, but real quick before we do your last song, what made you pick accordion though? I mean, of all.
He's a nerd.
Well,
nerd alert.
Well, I actually had a melodica when I was growing up, which is just the treble side of the accordion, and I loved it. And then. Got a little concertina, and I've just been upgrading ever since.
Very cool.
Oh, so you do have a concertina.
I don't have one anymore, but I used to.
Yeah. All right, well, I don't want to run out of time before you guys can play your last song, so let's go into that. This is the River City Healers, and yeah, we love them.
Okay.
There it was. Did you like it?
What's this one called?
This one is a tune that comes from New Orleans. This is called Tootie Ma's a Big Fine Thing.
Mm. Sounds good to me.
Y'all sing with me?
Mm-hmm.
A big fine thing, who not near swing that thing. Tootie Ma is a big fine thing, who not near swing that thing. Finest gal you ever saw, done some things against the law. Took my ma, stole my pa. I'm gonna knock on the door. Wait for me that Mardi Gras day. Nane, swing that thing. Swing for me that Mardi Gras day. Nane, swing that thing. Tootie Ma can drink some wine. Nane, drinks that fine. Tootie Ma can drink some wine. Nane, swing that thing. There she goes down the ramp, looking for some cat to vamp. Police come throw her right in jail. I'll get her out on bail. Wait for me that Mardi Gras day. Ooh, nah, nah, swing that thing. Mardi Gras day. Ooh, nah, nah, swing that thing. A big fine thing, ooh nah, nah, swing that thing. Tutima is a big fine thing, ooh nah, nah, swing that thing. Finest gal you ever saw, done some things against the law. Stole my ma, took my pa, I'm gonna knock on the door. Wait for me that Mardi Gras day. Nah, nah, swing that thing. Swing for me that Mardi Gras day. Ooh, nah, nah, swing that thing. Swing for me that Mardi Gras day. Ooh, nah, nah, swing that thing. Swing for me that Mardi Gras day. Ooh, nah, nah, swing that thing.
I fucking love this band. How was that?
Yeah.
Does that work for you?
Okay. Judy's Carson?
Yeah. Judy's Carson.
Oh, goodness me.
Internet radio. All right.
All right. Love it. All right, guys. This has been the River City Healers. Thank you so much. So
thank
much.
You.
This has been worth the wait.
It was an honor to be on here.
Yeah. Come back to so much fun. So, and thank you for all my co-hosts. Thank you for my engineers. This has just been a blast. So. Please tune in next time. This is Musical Notes on PANJ Radio. I'm Judith Marchand, and thank you for joining us, and thank you, River City Healers. Have a good night, everybody.